Imagine yourself out with friends or family and being deeply engaged in a conversation when all of a sudden you get a loud ringing in your ears or maybe a sudden pop. Then nothing. Absolute silence. This is actually a similar story to someone that I recently had the pleasure of interviewing named Richard, which wouldn't have been possible without today's video sponsor, Cochlear. Cochlear and I have teamed up to not only share Richard's story, but also shed some light on the new Cochlear Nucleus 7. Before we get into the Nucleus 7 though, let me introduce you to Richard and let him tell you a little bit more about his hearing history.
My name is Richard, and I was totally deaf for 35 years. I had scarlet fever when I was 5. I wore hearing aids till I was 30. And then one day I was riding the bus up Madison Avenue and my left ear went, could no longer use a hearing aid. 2 months later, I'm in the movies and my right ear went and I could no longer wear a hearing aid on that side. And I went totally silent for 35 years.
Richard told me off camera that he didn't know if it was a direct result of the scarlet fever for his hearing loss or if it was complications from the medication he had to take during that time. Regardless though, I couldn't imagine 1 minute being able to hear just completely fine and the next being deaf for the next 35 years. I started to think about it and it brought me to my next question, which was, what were some of the hardest things he had to deal with not being able to hear for that long period of time? And his answer surprised me.
The worst part of losing your hearing is the isolation you feel from your friends, your family. And you can be sitting in a group of people, you don't know what's going on, you're afraid to open your mouth because somebody will say, oh, we just spoke about that 10 minutes ago. And it's very, very, it's discouraging. And it's discouraging when people say, when you ask, what do they say? And they say, never mind, it's not important. It's probably the one most hurtful rejections you can ever feel.
Richard then went on to explain how he heard about Cochlear and also what he was initially waiting on to fix his hearing.
4 years ago, I discovered cochlear implants. They had been around when I lost my hearing, but they were very primitive. And I was waiting for science to find a cure for my deafness. And then I had misconceptions about cochlear implants. And 4 years ago, I ran into a gentleman who was wearing them and I started asking more about them and I investigated. In December of 2015, I had received bilateral cochlear implant surgery. I was activated in January of 2016 with 2 cochlear nucleus 6, and they restored my hearing.
Before we continue, let me quickly explain what Richard meant when he said he was activated. After a patient receives implant surgery, they have to undergo a 2 to 4 week healing process before the implant can be turned on and tuned. During the initial activation session, the goal is to find a comfortable volume level across the frequency spectrum. That way a sound plan can be mapped out. If the patient is able to determine a soft sound from a loud sound during the first appointment, then the session was successful. The first activation session is always very emotional. Given the fact that most of these people obtaining this procedure have not been able to hear for years, and hearing something as simple as a soft beep is a ray of sunshine beaming through stormy clouds. And in Richard's case, he not only was able to hear something, he regained all of his hearing.
It was not a magic bullet. It did require rehabilitation, which in fact was very pleasurable. Reading audiobooks and listening to audiobooks and listening to lectures, listening to music, and my hearing did come back. A fully restored hearing.
Isn't it crazy? Richard was able to go from being deaf for 35 years to regaining all of his hearing using the Cochlear Nucleus 6. And the Nucleus 7 is even more powerful. But before we get into the Nucleus 7, I asked Richard, what is the difference between a cochlear implant and a hearing aid? Given that most people, myself included, probably think these two are very similar.
A cochlear implant is not a hearing aid. Hearing aids basically amplify the sound, and at some point, the amplification may be there, but you can't comprehend what's going on, and people give up. Amplification does not increase comprehension in many, many cases, because what happens inside the inner ear of the cochlea, there are about 30,000 hair cells, and when those hair cells start to die, comprehension disappears. The cochlear implant basically replaces the electrical impulses and it sends a signal to the brain, which the brain interprets as hearing. It sounds perfectly natural, absolutely the way I remembered it from 35 years ago.
I was curious, if the Nucleus 6 was just so good, why did Richard want to upgrade to the Nucleus 7? In fact, why does anybody want to upgrade, or why should they upgrade to the Nucleus 7 from the Nucleus 6 if they've already regained complete functionality? Well, Richard's gonna tell us.
And in July of 2017, Cochlear introduced the Nucleus 7, and it was light years ahead of anything else. It was worked with the cooperation of Apple. It tied in with the iPhone.
So if you guys are unaware, towards the end of 2017, Cochlear announced the Nucleus 7, which was pretty much a Nucleus 6 with a couple key differences that really take hearing implants to the next level. Cochlear partnered with Apple in order to create the Nucleus 7, which can connect to an iPhone 5 or later through Bluetooth low energy audio. Sound familiar? It should, because Apple's AirPods use similar technology and in fact were unveiled right around the same time the Nucleus 7 was announced. Pretty mind-blowing. Using this iPhone connection, patients can stream audio from music and movies that are playing on their phone. They can control their device. They can make and take phone calls and presumably anything that a standard Bluetooth connection is capable of. More so, within the Cochlear Nucleus 7 app, you can adjust profiles, tweak audio frequencies, and monitor the Nucleus 7. Let's go ahead and go back to Richard and let's hear what he thinks of the Nucleus 7.
Is the best thing that ever happened to me. I enjoy it so much. And this is one of the reasons why I keep trying to talk to people and spread the awareness about what a cochlear implant is. Very few people have it. Americans have 50 million people with hearing loss. A large number of them cannot be helped with a hearing aid anymore. And the awareness of what a cochlear implant is about is basically what my goal is, to reach out to people and say, look at this. You don't have to live in deafness. You don't have to live in isolation. And I've been doing that now for 3 years. But what's so wonderful about the Cochlear Nucleus 7 is the direct streaming. When a phone call comes, I can just hit a button and I can talk on the phone. It streams right to my head. And just to demonstrate what a cochlear implant is, it's basically a processor and a coil. And the coil goes right to the magnet that's inside my head and an internal processor and a small wire that leads into the cochlear with 22 electrodes. Those 22 electrodes are interpreted as sound.
Finally, before saying goodbye to Richard, who was just an amazing guest, he had a few words of encouragement to share as well as some helpful tips.
I urge you that this is not a joke. This is something you really need to be careful about. Now, as much as I appreciate what I have, I would never wish it on anybody to need one. So please, just be careful, and be careful of your hearing.
Make sure to check out the link down below in the description if you want to know more about the Cochlear Nucleus 7. It will take you over directly to Cochlear's website, and you can find all the information you may need. This project was something new and different, and by far one of the most heartwarming and eye-opening videos I have ever had a chance to work on. I just want to give a huge shout out to Cochlear again for making this video possible and bringing awareness to the Nucleus 7 and letting people know you don't have to go on living anymore without hearing. It is possible to regain your hearing. You just have to do a little bit of the legwork. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them down below in a comment. If you guys enjoyed this video, do be sure to like it and share it with someone that might benefit from watching it. If you guys are new here, stick around by subscribing, and I will talk to you guys in the next video.